This is Pokhara, and behind those clouds over there are the biggest mountains in the world, the Himalayas. On Sunday, or maybe Monday, we're not sure yet, we're going to start trekking through them up to Mount Everest Base Camp. It's now Thursday. The gang are arriving on Saturday. We're all very much looking forward to it, a little bit apprehensive. But this film is going to document our journey.
Namaste! Welcome!
Hi.
You alright?
Yeah, great, mate.
Alright, namaste!
Alright, mate.
And so, in Kathmandu, seven friends assemble, ready to climb more than 5 kilometers into the sky.
Are you apprehensive?
No, I'm very much a chilled out kind of
trekker. Guys, are you feeling nervous?
Nervous about the yogurt.
No, I'm talking about the trek. Yeah,
it's just a big hill. How hard could it be?
Their first obstacle was the flight to Lukla, one that has claimed many lives before.
Oh, hi there. We're just about to get on the world's most dangerous flight. I'm actually quite nervous.
A little nervous.
Yeah. Nervous. Final flight.
Can't wait.
Take off.
Sweaty palms.
Safely in the mountains, their journey begins in earnest. A 10-day trek up to Everest Base Camp.
Now entering the park.
Okay, off-road. Namaste.
Lots. You take a lot of photo. You came here for photo.
Good karma.
Yes.
We're doing this for good karma.
Well, our trip, that's good weather.
Wide-eyed, they set out.
Wow!
Namaste!
Okay?
Yeah. Great to go. Clark's got a great face, that yak, hasn't
he? What?
How are you finding his first day? Anything to say?
The mountains have their own rules, and it's clear our team will have to learn to live by them.
Good day so far?
Brilliant. I'm waiting for some dal bat.
Yeah.
You want the dal bat?
I cancelled our order and ordered 7 lots of dal bat.
I'm literally having a great day. I'm really enjoying it. It's very fun.
Highlights?
I must admit, it's been
the bridges
a lot easier than I thought.
Were a good one.
We haven't edged on the
mainly, I just love drinking out of the straw.
feeling good.
Is it too?
Dreading this afternoon.
You know, I do think I had a couple of ups. Out of breath quite quickly.
A lot of ups, a lot of downs.
A lot of downs.
Big ups still to come.
Bearings go excited.
I think we'll do it in less than 2 hours.
Pumped, man.
I don't think it's too
The afternoon brings the first real challenge, an uphill climb, one of the steepest of their expedition. It begins on a bridge named after a true hero of the region.
Tell us the name of the bridge.
Okay, the Tulare Bridge. Bridge.
Hillary Bridge.
Yeah, who's the, you know, the famous person, Hillary?
The famous person.
Met some Danes on the way up.
What did they say?
They told us that anything above
is hell up there.
Is hell. And two of their party heli evacuated, which, you know.
No, there was 15 of them.
Oh, there's 15. We only saw four on the way, or five on the way back.
So, actually, we've all done really well.
Pat on the back so far. But by those statistics of our seven, not many are going to come back.
Odds on who should have gone first?
I think so.
Tail.
Should we all put in
our cameraman?
Imagine if the film the film ends in Namche.
But the film doesn't end in Namche. Our explorers make it to the Himalayan capital, a bustling town some 10 days' walk from the nearest road.
There, we've made it to Namche.
Here it is.
The famous stupa.
The Sherpa capital.
Of the world.
This is their London.
An important milestone on a long journey.
Good morning.
Good morning.
This is our third day.
We had to continue.
It's our rest day today, but we don't want to rest. We want to get up 5 a.m.
sunrise.
Stairs
through
and then
trek.
But it is stunning, so it's worth it.
On this majestic morning, the team realized the scale of their ambitions. All of them see for the first time their destination, their endpoint, the reason they came. Sagarmatha, Mount Everest, the top of the world.
Right now we see, you know, this is the viewpoint, okay, and the, from here you see the holy mountain. You see the Mount Everest, first you see the Mount Everest. First day you see the Everest viewpoint.
Is the one on the left or the right?
The middle one. Yeah, intimidated, Dale, to be honest.
Yeah. Okay, slowly.
It looks a long way away.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay, nice view.
It's our first sighting.
Mount Everest, and then the rest of the other Amadablam.
And that afternoon, at the highest airstrip in the world, the pressure mounts.
We cannot breathe.
The first tears of the trip.
Is this your water, though? Can I have a bit more refill with mine?
Yeah. Amy, are you okay?
I just was feeling, first of all, I couldn't really breathe. I was like this. With every step, and then I was kind of worrying about the fact that if I was like this now, what would I be like later? Would I make it? Might I keel over? I got very emotional and then I cried.
This dramatic episode was followed by their first sight of acute mountain sickness.
And we also saw a rather rotund lady smoke four cigarettes and then pass out.
I was more of a fit.
She was making... Neil, can you do an example of the noise?
It was a very guttural kind of...
It's like the Doctor Who baddie, I'm not sure which
one. It was actually like a gurgling
train. Cautiously, they continue. Higher and higher.
Once there was a mountain called Peak 15. Nothing was known about it. But in 1852, the surveyors found it was the highest in the world, and they named it Everest.
I think, you know, people are starting to feel the effects of the altitude. Morale, group morale is still high, though. But certainly, symptoms are starting to show. I think this is the beginning of the end.
Pretty tired, are you?
The beginning is always the hardest bit.
And then what?
And it gets not often harder.
Feels like he's stumbling.
Drunken. Feels like a drunken.
He feels like a drunken.
When men were first drawn to Everest, it was an unknown quantity. Something entirely beyond them.
It's bloody hard. It's a hard journey. It's long.
Do you think in general it's harder than you thought it was going to be, this?
No, it's about what I thought it would be.
Yeah.
Actually, it wasn't as hard as the first day. Actually quite enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Well, today was a real struggle, I must admit. I woke up with a cracking AMS. That's severe. I'm probably lucky to be alive here.
It's been a long day. Very, very long. Mm. I feel pretty tired. But Everest is over there. She's hiding herself from us. She's being elusive. But hopefully we're going to wake up in the morning and see where our final destination is.
Tomorrow's where the altitude...
Tomorrow's where we're told that people start getting sent home. 4-4. 4-4, this is where people start properly puking.
It's where shit gets real.
Yeah.
The air is getting thinner and thinner. At such heights, when you're lacking oxygen, you may think you're long, but you're not. You're moving in a dream that deludes and debilitates.
The lack of oxygen means that trees can no longer survive at this level. And it's very much only shrub. This is a shrub.
Promisingly, the more our team climb, the stronger they feel.
Just broken through 4,000 metres.
I've kicked altitude sickness in the butt.
Yes, how do you do that?
A cocktail of drugs. But this morning, Phil, on the bend, so fingers crossed for a happy ascent.
Probably the best I've felt so far, which is strange as we are going up.
Why should a man climb Everest? Because it is there.
With 2 days to go, the team spend time bonding in camp.
We have just arrived at Dukla, which is in between Dingboche and Lamboche. It's been a good walk so far today.
I actually think it's been the best walk.
Dale's favourite walk
we've had
to date.
Very pleasant.
I think it's been excellent.
But extremely hard and difficult.
Very hard.
Nice poo, Amy.
The next morning provides time for reflection.
A memorial spot for all the fallen previous summiters and not so lucky summiters.
What to do, Cameron? Do big party.
So we're getting pretty close to free.
Explorers stumbled tiredly into their final rest point, sparing just enough time to be reminded of the danger that lurks around every corner so high up in the Himalayas.
The shit's hit the fan today.
Two helicopter rescues.
There.
Both of them there.
Both there. And snow. Guys out!
We're gonna get quite wet.
You know the guy who got heli-evac'd?
Yeah?
The guy that keeps talking to us.
Whoa! Patrick!
You get a photo next to the yaks because they're tied up.
Patrick! It's snowing! Patrick! seeing how close he can get to a yak after he was previously attacked. Pat, go on.
Go on, get me close.
Go on, pussy.
No, he's gonna love me.
Chicken!
Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Never let it fade away.
Never let it fade away.
Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket. Save it for a
moment. Come on, take the lad out the boy.
That doesn't make sense.
I will move. I'm happy to moon. I'm not going to get full naked.
Tomorrow, base camp.
Are you? Do you think you'll be okay for base camp, Dale?
Now I've got this far.
Guaranteed by
Homnaf. Now I've got this far.
Homnaf has
guaranteed.
And
we're
going
to get to base camp, aren't we?
It's here. The day they have been climbing for.
Big, big day.
It ain't more.
Base camp.
Top of the morning.
Assemble.
Big day, Pat.
Big day. Big day. Big, big day.
Twelve hours to Everest Base Camp.
Going up to base camp today. Got the ice picks out. Big day. Just got a spud of ludicrous. Casual.
This is it.
EBC. I'm looking forward to it, I'm excited. I mean, we can see it in the distance, we could anyway. It's now obscured by more mountain. It's a nice sunny day, there's a peppering of snow on the ground, it's beautiful. A blanket of white.
Pat's got his explorer glasses on.
Just broken through 5,000 the first time.
Feeling good.
Out of breath.
I'm feeling great. A little out of breath, but that's to be expected at this high altitude.
Yeah?
Yeah.
This is really it now.
The final
walk.
The final 2 hours.
2 hours to go. How are you feeling?
Tired.
Guy?
Touched. Elated.
It's a beautiful day. It's probably our nicest day so far. We've got a 2 hour trek to base camp. I think spirits are quite high.
Morale's high.
Morale is high.
The last mile.
Priceless.
How long do you reckon?
Hour and a half.
So close!
They've done it. Mount Everest Base Camp. Their memories will last a lifetime. Their friendships are sealed. But today, this glorious day,
4 weeks ago,
they all agree on the one thing.
It is the greatest day of my human life.
One thing got them there. And that was their TAC-TIC.
Try not to sing, gotta keep. Oh, I get by with a little.
morning we're supposed to be leaving from Lukla to Kathmandu. We were supposed to leave about an hour ago. As you can see, it doesn't look like we're going anywhere just yet.
This is the runway.
No planes have come in yet this morning.
Dying. 2 days of stranded.
The past 2 days we've been stranded because of the adverse weather conditions, very low clouds. Now,
and how do you
we've
feel?
We've coughed up and we're paying for a copter.
Yeah. Mixture of emotions, nerves, excitement, relief. Never been on a helicopter.
Oh, I feel like a refugee.
So, the others got out on a helicopter, but it only seated six. I was hoping to get on one as well, but a storm came, I couldn't. Stuck here in Lukla, a trip that started with a bribe and I left my wallet in the airport has ended with a bribe. We've paid off a man at the airport who's hopefully going to bump me to the top of the waiting list. We'll see.
Okay, go home. Yeah. Go home. Later. Good job.